From your Cape Coral News team, one canal could impact your health long term. Researchers actually want some of you to stay near it for now.
NBC2's Claire Lavazzorio explains what benefits you'd get if you want to be a part of this study.
We're alongside the Highlander Canal. Take a look. Today there is a little bit of a green tint to the water. Neighbors tell me they're experiencing mild symptoms like a cough or itchy eyes, but depending on the results of this new study, some may be ready to move and say goodbye to canal living.
Daryl Dunbar is used to dealing with algae blooms in his backyard. His Cape Coral home backs up to the Highlander Canal near Skyline Boulevard.
Within the past couple of days, if you can see, there's a very green hue now that's on the surface.
We first met Dunbar in September of 2020 when his canal was full of toxic blue-green algae. He's worried that will return, unsure what it means for his health and the health of his family.
It would be nice to have a study. I already have health issues. Is this going to increase any health issues that I do have? I really don't know.
That's the question researchers are trying to answer too.
You don't know how efficiently the body is able to clear those toxins, or if those toxins are stored in the body, we just don't know. And that's why we're doing the study.
Florida Atlantic University's Dr. Shirley Gordon says they need 30 new volunteers, 18 and up, who live or work near canals to undergo testing. If you're selected, you'll be a part of two data collection sessions, when algae is blooming and when it is not. Researchers know there are acute effects to algae exposure, like respiratory irritation, but it's unclear how long the toxins stay in our bodies. It's a study Dunbar says he's interested in to figure out if his dream home is detrimental to his health.
I've been here almost 20 years now. Will it make me move? It may. We'll just have to see what happens. Hopefully it doesn't kill me.
The testing will take place at the end of this month. If you are selected, you'll be required to provide a nasal swab as well as a blood and urine sample. If you'd like more information on how to participate, visit our website under News Links. I'm in Cape Coral, Claire Lavazzorio, NBC2.